Now that we have the internet involved in what we now more globally call social media, all of that stuff needs to be sorted, understood, and so on. And I don't think we've begun to. I mean, in some ways, here's where I was going with that. We have used all this information on the internet to sort of challenge the validity of mainstream media, right? They're all biased. You don't need to listen to them. Go on YouTube and figure it out yourself. As we get better at this, maybe we can do that. But at some level, we have to be able to ferret out what is a reliable source and what is not. There's a graph there. Just because it's a graph or just because it's numbers doesn't mean it means anything. Who generated it? What were the questions asked? Who did they talk to? Can we believe that they actually did that? I mean, all of that stuff we have to have in our toolkit before we can make these judgments ourselves. And we used to rely on a handful of mainstream media sources to do that for us. That is less the case now, right? And so I think people are going to have to find a happy medium. They're going to have to find reliable sources that they can trust, put the pieces together themselves. And I think we're doing it to some degree by following the social media links of people that we trust. But I think Dane's absolutely right. We're not there yet. And as a result, we leave ourselves more vulnerable to things like conspiracy theories and misinformation. I oftentimes start this section in US government class by saying, has the internet made us smarter or dumber? And I think a case can be made both ways. I think myself, I would say it gives us the potential to be smarter. But right now in this phase, it's probably making us dumber.